Hey y'all, cooking, cutting up, keeping it real, lemon pound cake is what I'm making today. I have put 2 sticks of butter, which is 1 cup, and an 8-ounce package of cream cheese in this dish. And I put it in the microwave for about 40 seconds just to soften it. So I'm gonna get started mixing. I'm gonna take 8 tablespoons, which is a 1/2 stick of butter flavored Crisco. And I'm gonna add the 2 sticks of butter and the 1 8-ounce package of cream cheese softened. You can put those on the counter and have them at room temperature if you prefer. I just didn't have time to do that today. I'm going to add 3 cups of white granulated sugar. This recipe is found in my cookbook, Granny's Farm to Table. It's on page 74. I have double yolked eggs as well, so I'm going to do 5 of those instead of 6 regular size eggs. It's going to be delicious. I'm going to give this a spin while I crack my eggs. Well, said it was. There we go. So we're going to cream that. These came from a friend of mine, Michelle Prophet. She brings me double yolked eggs about twice a year. And they are straight out of the chicken's behind. So I have washed them carefully. I'm going to go ahead and crack them into here. These double yolked eggs will make it really rich and delicious. Some pound cake recipes call for 5 eggs, some call for 6. And if you have double yolked eggs, I'm going to use 5. Okay, I'm going to add in 1 egg at a time, or try to, and give that a spin. I act like I'm talking about laundry here. Sifted 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1 teaspoon of salt, and set it to the side. So let me recap for those of you that are writing this down. 1/2 stick of butter flavored Crisco, which is 8 tablespoons. 1 8-ounce package of cream cheese softened. 2 sticks of butter softened, which is 1 cup. And then 1 egg at a time. I use double yolk eggs, so I used 5. If you have regular size eggs, you can use 6. It's totally up to you on that. Now I'm gonna alternate mixing in my dry ingredients. Bit more. I've also already greased my pan with Crisco and then floured it with all-purpose flour. I'm gonna let that mix really well while I grab some powdered sugar. Thank you. I'm gonna clean up my mess as I go. And I'm gonna let that continue to mix. I'm gonna scrape down the sides. And into this, okay, now, you know what, I'll go ahead and pop that in the oven. I'm gonna show you the lemon drizzle as well. Here's the best part of baking a pound cake, in my opinion. Love to lick the batter. I'm gonna also add in my extract, which I actually almost forgot. I'm gonna do 2 teaspoons of lemon, and I'm gonna do about equal amounts of vanilla bean paste. And ideally you would mix that, but now that I've licked that, I'm not gonna mix it with that. I'm gonna mix it with this. Smells heavenly. When I tasted it, I realized that I forgot the extract. I have a dear friend that brings me these double yolked eggs about twice a year. They make the best pound cakes. Okay, now let me make some room here. And this is my pan. And I grease mine pretty heavily with Crisco and then flour them so that that baby comes out easily and quickly. And then we'll do the lemon drizzle. Where's my spatula? I have hit, Lord have mercy. If it had been a snake, it'd have bit me. Okay. And we love a pound cake around here. And I'll be taking half of this to profits for being so generous with the eggs. And half of it I'll leave here for the hubs. And me. I don't know about y'all, but my husband, if I have a pound cake, he eats it for breakfast. And then he'll eat a piece at, after supper sometimes, but always for breakfast. Set this to the side. Okay, 325 degrees for 70 minutes in my oven. Usually I tell people an hour and 10 to an hour and 15, but you have to gauge your oven. Let me pop that in. Okay. Now, the drizzle. I go ahead and mix my drizzle up and have it ready because I like to put it on the pound cake while the pound cake is still hot. So I'm going to take one lemon, the juice of one lemon. This was a big one. And I'm going to get my zester. I'm going to put some zest in here first. No, ma'am. I have my almost 6-month-old puppy loves to hop up here and steal my washcloth so when I lay them where she can get to them. I go through a lot of washcloths, let's just say that.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to juice this. This is a big lemon. Love baking a pound cake, makes the house smell so good. Okay, and to that, I'm gonna add powdered sugar. Grab a towel. I saw you got my washcloth, girlfriend. You didn't fool me. So I'm gonna add a little bit at a time. Give it a stir. You want this to be about the thickness of Elmer's glue. That's the best way I can describe the thickness of this drizzle, that glaze that I put on top of my pound cakes, especially my lemon ones. There we go. And you can add a little bit of warm water if you need to. But that is about the consistency that I like. Okay, I'll set that to the side. When that pound cake comes out, I'm gonna turn it out and I'm gonna glaze it, let it cool. Cut it in two, take half of it to a friend, keep half here. Lemon pound cake. If you are one of those people that want one of the cookbooks, you can go to cookingcuttingup.com. And you can get those in the online store. There's Mama's Always Right and Granny's Farm to Table. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see y'all. Bye-bye.